Hello, and thanks for choosing to watch my video on how to make a bullet tone bar for lap or steel Hawaiian guitar. First of all, I'm going to demonstrate the toughness of stainless steel. I've got four different metals: aluminium, brass, mild steel, stainless steel. What I'll do is cut each one, and they're all the same thickness. I've turned them to 18 millimetres, if they weren't already 18 millimetres, just to see how easy the saw gets through them. We'll start with with aluminium. I'll time how long it takes. Next we'll do the brass. Mild steel should take longer still. See straight away that's taking a lot longer than the brass. It's quite tough steel, so we'll see how long it takes to get through. Again there. So this is ordinary mild steel. That's 55 seconds that I made it. Put that one out. I'll try the stainless steel bar. You can see how slowly the saw's going through. But stainless steel is quite a lot harder than any of the other metals. We're already just about up to where the mild steel bar was cut. And we're about halfway. So down through. Could put more pressure on the saw to speed it up a little bit, but obviously to keep the test accurate for each bar, I've just let the saw do the work on its own. Almost through. Stop me stopwatch. I can't quite see what it says to me. Hand is hiding it. So that is $154, so literally twice as long as it took to cut the ordinary steel bar. First operation is to turn the dome on the end. This is my homemade dome cutter. You vary the radius of the dome by just adjusting the tool length to where it cuts the metal. So start that one up. A bit of oil. Get you off. Move it in slightly. Just gently take the metal down. Keep moving it forward. Hopefully you can see now that I'm about almost halfway. Vibrating a little bit, that's what that noise is. That should be okay. You can see how the metal gets, the oil goes on this, that's smoking as you cut the metal. One's supposed to happen. see it starting to take shape now. Just about there. Last couple of cuts. I do quite slow. Not that one. I'm sure it's quite nicely round here. Just so we get a good finish on there as I possibly can. It's easier for polishing. So you can have a look at the finish from that edge. Right. And that's all done. So we've got the lathe set up for the next operation, which is to put the thumb recess in the other end. Let's start it up. This is a cobalt steel drill for drilling stainless steel. You won't get away with an ordinary drill. So I'm going to do about a 5mm hole in the end. 5mm hole. Well, now I've set the lathe up for doing a small taper in the end with the thumb recess. It might be a bit of a dodgy bit of camera work, so I've got holding the camera in my hands. I can't get a good view of the lathe anywhere, really. So you just turn in like that. You can't take off too much at once. You steadily go in. The reason I drilled the hole first before I started doing this gives us the tool some to bite onto, and also gives me a level of depth of how deep I want the hole. So it's either too deep or not deep enough, I can adjust the taper accordingly later on. Virtually there. You can see how that taper is coming along. Nice and slowly for these last couple of runs. About right. What I'll do next, important not to come out too far, take the edge off the back and shorten the bar, it's measured to length. So just leave a little bit around the outside. Oops. See, that's just about done. Thumb fits in there nicely. Good. I'll smooth that out with a bit of emery cloth and soften the back edge by putting a tiny taper on the edge so the edge doesn't cut into your finger, and then the next step will be polishing. So now we come to the polishing part. This is a sateen mop. It's got an abrasive paste applied to the mop. This will take out the machine marks and just smooth the top of the metal over. Let's keep the work moving. This operation, because there aren't any flat spots. Just looking at all the marks out. Go around the back edge, so we're just swapping that over a little bit more. First operation done. You can see it's a bit oily because we've grease off my hands and gloves. The next one. Next is the size of it. So this is the sisal mop you're going to use. This is a green resin treated sisal. It's a little bit harder than a standard sisal. It's just a coarse string mop. They just screw onto the end of the spindle. Get me gloves on. This is me polishing jig for tone bars. Oh, it is a piece of wood which the bar will slide into. This is because the mop puts a lot of friction against the work and can easily, if you're just holding your hands, can easily jump out of your hand and hit the floor, put a ding in it. Also, it does get very hot, even with thick gloves on, it'll burn through the gloves. So by doing this, you don't have to handle it quite as much. This hot, take that out of there. Been polished too. Got where I put me polish. There it is. See, I was looking for a bigger bar and I got a new bar somewhere. This it's okay. Right, it's taking a little while to get all the to get the finish you need. So I'll just stop the video there. So that's it, it's finished size there. I don't know if you can see what the finish is like after a sizal. The light it sort of reflects a bit. So it's just like a bright finish. Sometimes with stainless steel you'd leave this as a finished product. I'm going for a mirror finish. So I've changed the mop to a stitch mop, using a now which is an intermediate mop and an intermediate polish. Just a cotton mop, so softer than the sisal. And I'll take out the sisal marks. You can see how the end's more shiny now than before. It's the dome done. Put it back in the gear. That polish. And there you go again. This is the finishing mop, that's the final finish on it. It's a very soft white cotton mop. And then a fine polish to finish it. do need to be careful because there's quite a lot of drag on this knot. You could still snap it out of your hand. You need to get quite a bit of pressure on. You can see how that's coming out nice and shiny now, almost there. Obviously the gloves. I've left it greasy. So what I do now is take them off. So, taking the gloves off, just putting on a pair of soft cotton gloves. Just so that I don't need any greasy now. Wipe that off with a cotton rag. Okay. You have to see the final finish. All finished. there's the finished product. If you can see there.